Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. In this video, I will be discussing a slew of very important questions. So without wasting any time, I will be moving on to our first question. But before that, the students who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also guys, this channel, I would like to tell you about this channel a bit more. So this channel is the doubt resolving platform where you can ask your queries related to your exam or preparation. And here we provide free quizzes as well. So if you want to appear for the quizzes like English, Reasoning, Quant, GK, you can enroll yourself in this group and enjoy the free quizzes that are provided here. Now we have come across our first question. So recently, a committee of Ministry of Education has recommended that IITs should be exempted from following reservation policies in faculty recruitment. Who is the head of this committee? So first of all, this committee was formed for the purpose of suggesting measures for implementing reservation policies in IITs. IITs stand for Indian Institute of Technology. So how the government can implement reservation policies in IITs, that was the function of this committee. Now this committee has submitted its recommendations, and among the recommendations, the most prominent recommendation is right here in front of you in the question itself. That is prohibit implementing the reservation policy in recruiting faculties. Now, who is the head of this committee? So this committee is chaired by V. Ram Gopal Rao. He is a very important personality because he is the director of IIT Delhi. And IIT Delhi is an important institute, and he is the director of IIT Delhi, also the chairman of this committee that was formed to suggest measures to implement reservation policies in IIT. So first major recommendation is right here, that is prohibit the reservation policy in faculty recruitment. Rather, this committee suggests that instead of giving reservation in faculty recruitment, promote the PhD level research or PhD level education among the reserved category students, so that they become capable in themselves, that so that they can get job at IIT on the basis of their merit and not reservation. So basically, this committee has suggested that the government should introduce programs like research assistantship, so that the reserved category students can be encouraged to adopt PhD courses. And in this manner, their merit can be increased. So that is the whole crux of the recommendations that are provided by the Ram Gopal Rao committee. Now, we are leaving out one most important question here. That is, when was this committee formed? So this committee was formed in the month of April 2020. So this is really a very recent committee. It was formed in 2020 only. Therefore, high chances that it can be asked in the examination. So that's all for this question. And now here we are at our second question. So with which country has India recently signed 7 agreements, including one for creating a CEOs forum? So can you make a guess here that which country it is? So let me give you a hint. The Prime Minister of this country is Sheikh Hasina. So this is quite 100% hint that I have given to you. So you would be sure of the answer. So what is the answer? It is Bangladesh. So recently, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina of Bangladesh and Prime Minister Narendra Modi of India, they have conducted the bilateral virtual summit. And during that summit, 7 agreements for cooperation in various fields like hydrocarbons, agriculture, textile, elephant conservation, or garbage management. So such kinds of agreements have been signed by both these countries, including one for creating this CEO forum. Now guys, there were not many informations related to the CEO forum given by the prime ministers of both the countries. They have just said that they will be creating a CEO forum, but what would be the mechanism and what would be the functionality of this forum, that has not been cleared yet. So whenever the details come out, I will tell you in this session only. Now, for the time being, let's restrict ourselves to the information that we have for now. So during this summit, this bilateral summit between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Sheikh Hasina, they discussed, or we can say they inaugurated, a rail line. So you must have come across this rail line, which is quite in news. So this Chilihati is in Bangladesh and Haldibari is in West Bengal. This rail line was there in operation till 1965, and after 1965 it was stopped from operation. Now it has been inaugurated, it has been relaunched, so reopened, this rail link. So this is a step towards connecting Bangladesh with India more. So remember this rail link, remember the agreements with Bangladesh. Also, the Indian government has also mentioned that a film on the life of Mujibur Rahman. So Bangabandhu Mujibur Rahman, father of Bangladesh, and also the father of Sheikh Hasina. So Sheikh Hasina is the biological daughter of Bangabandhu. So there would be a film on him, on a biopic on Mujibur Rahman, that would be filmed by Indian government. So India will be filming it, and who will be directing this film? It will be directed by Shyam Benegal. So guys, this is not a new announcement. It was announced quite a month back. So therefore, you should remember that Shyam Benegal is the director of the biopic that is being filmed by India on Bangabandhu Mujibur Rahman. So that's all. These were the major facts. Apart from this, there was a commemorative stamp also that India released on Mujibur Rahman. So these are some of the facts. Now, related to India and Bangladesh, there is one interesting fact that I want to tell you. And that fact is that recently, India and Bangladesh conducted their second India-Bangladesh Cotton Fest. Second edition of India Bangladesh Cotton Fest. Now guys, you should also know this thing, that Bangladesh is one of the largest exporter of ready-made garments. And in order to produce ready-made garments, Bangladesh needs cotton that is provided by India. So India is one of the major exporter of cotton for Bangladesh, and in order to keep their cotton trade afloat, this second edition of this fest was recently organized by India and Bangladesh. So that's all for this news. There were nothing much facts related to this fact, but remember this thing, that cotton is one of the major important articles that both these countries trade with each other. Recently, ISRO has established NETRA, a dedicated control center for space situational awareness activities in the country. Where is it located? So this NETRA is basically a system that is launched to monitor the space assets of India, and in order to protect them from getting hit by the debris in the space. So for that purpose, this NETRA has been established by ISRO. Now, where has it been established? So the right answer is Pune. This is a city in Bangalore, Karnataka. So this is basically an area in Bangalore where this system has been established. Now the system has been established at a center. Now what is the name of that center? The name is ISRO Telemetry Tracking and Command Network. So this is the name of that center that is located in Peenya, Bangalore, where this Netra system has been established. Now the purpose is clear of Netra, that is to monitor the space situational activities, that is to monitor the Indian space assets. That is the one line purpose of this Netra, of establishing this Netra system. We have also discussed its location, the center at which it is located. Now, apart from this, Netra also has a full form. So what is the full form of Netra? Let's have a look at that. This, guys, is the full form of Netra, Network for Space Assets Tracking and Analysis. Clearly, from the full form, it is clear that the purpose of this Netra is to track and analyze the Indian space assets and the space situation. Now, you would be confused between this Netra and the Netra that Indian Railways is also experimenting with. So what is the difference? First of all, the major difference between the Netra that Indian Railways is trying and this Netra center. The major difference is that the Netra that Indian Railways is trying is Tri-Netra. The name is Tri-Netra. So this Indian Railway system, Tri-Netra, is for observing the obstructions that are there on the track when there is fog. So in order to prevent the railway accidents, this Tri-Netra is still in the experimentation for stage. Indian Railways is experimenting with this Tri-Netra system. And this Netra system has been launched by ISRO in order to monitor the Indian space assets. So these two things are clearly different. Don't get confused between these two things. Now, next question is really important. What is India's rank in the Human Freedom Index 2020? So we have been given an index. What is the first thing that we should ask from ourselves whenever we are covering the index? Which organization has released this index? So the index is released by Cato Institute and Fraser Institute. So this Cato is an American think tank and this Fraser is located in Canada. So these two organizations have launched this Human Freedom Index 2020. Now from the name Human Freedom Index, it is clear that this index measures the freedom that is provided to the humans in countries. Now this freedom is measured on 76 indicators. And these indicators are clubbed into three categories. So these three categories are human, economic and personal freedom. Human freedom, economic freedom and personal freedom. So these are the three broad categories under which the 76 indicators are clubbed, and these 76 indicators are used to assess a total number of 169 countries. Now, which country has given the most freedom to its human, to its subjects? It is New Zealand. And which country has the least human freedom? That is Syria. Of course, Syria is a militancy affected country. Therefore, we can ourselves assess that this would be Syria only. So Syria is at the bottom. New Zealand is at the top. Now, this let's discuss the answer of this question. That is India's rank. So India's rank is 111. Now guys, you would be amazed to know this thing, that this is a drastic fall in India's rank. In last year in 2019, India scored 94th rank and now it has dropped drastically to 111. So this is a drastic fall that India has witnessed. Apart from this, what is the score of India in 2020? So the score is 6.43. Remember the overall score of India in this index. So guys, we have discussed everything related to this index. And now I'm moving on to our next question. Which of the following organization has proposed Digital Service Act and Digital Market Act? So these two acts are very simple. There are no factual data related to these two acts. What provisions do these acts contain? That I will tell you a little later. But first of all, let's discuss the answer of this question. So which organization among the options have proposed these two acts? It is European Union. So European Union have proposed the Digital Services Act and Digital Markets Act in order to control the activities of major tech giants. So you must have come across Google, Amazon, Apple, Facebook. The collective name for these four companies is JAFA. So you must have come across this whole debate of JAFA tax. I'm not going into this JAFA tax thing, but I'm just alluding to this thing so that you can remember how these four tech giants are creating economic situations, economic trouble for European countries. So in order to resolve that economic trouble, European Union has launched this or proposed these two acts. So under this Markets Act, unfair competitive activities will be prevented, will be prohibited. And under this Services Act, the companies will be made liable for the content they post. So these are the major contents of these two acts. Apart from this, as I said earlier also, there are no facts related to these acts. So basic facts are that much only. You have to remember only this much for your examination. So what is India's GDP growth rate for FY22 according to SBI's EcoWrap report? First of all, guys, the State Bank of India's EcoWrap report is, I would say, that only is the only major report provided by a commercial bank in India related to India's GDP forecast. No other commercial bank in India, no other domestic bank in India provide the GDP forecast for the country. So it's just the SBI's EcoWrap report that does so. Therefore, it is important for you to remember. Now, for FY21, that is 2021 to 2022, the GDP rate is 11%, and for 2020 to 2021, the GDP rate is minus 7.4%. So earlier this was around 10%, but now it has been upgraded to 7.4% by keeping in view the recovery that was there in second quarter of this year. So that's all for this question. Now our next question is, when was International Convention on the Protection of the Rights of All Migrants, Migrant Workers and Members of Their Families adopted? So this International Convention was adopted on 18th December 1990. So option C is the right answer. So it was adopted on 18 December 1990 and it was implemented or it came into force in 2003. So remember these two things. Now on 18 December, we have a special day that we observe, and that day is International Migrants Day. So this day is specifically observed on this date because of this convention, because this convention was adopted on this day. So in 2020, also this day was observed. And what was the theme in 2020? It was reimagining human mobility. Reimagining human mobility. So that is the theme of International Migrants Day 2020 that is observed on 18 December. So that's all for this question. And here I would like to take leave from you guys. I hope that you have learned a lot. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do share it with your friends and do come back tomorrow as well. Thank you.